let's start by the default scene. I'm going to delete all the default elements. We have Quixel Bridge. I've downloaded certain assets from here, which we can export to Blender directly. So this is the asset which I thought we should be using for this trial. So this is how the model looks. Let's go back, and I've already downloaded this. I should be able to export it straight away to Blender. Once it's exported, we should be able to see the model, something like this. Let's go ahead and check how the texture looks on this one. This is how it looks. So now what I'm planning is a particle, like a small sphere, should come from this side, collide with this object and break it to pieces and then go away. And this should all happen in a slow motion kind of shot. So if we are able to figure that fracturing part, we should be able to move ahead and set up a scene and get some renders out of this. Let's actually do one thing. Let's select the object, go to the edit mode. We just need to make sure that it has a decent enough, dense enough geometry, which this object definitely seems to have, so we don't need to bother breaking it down even more. Cell fracture is basically an add-on which comes default with Blender. To enable that, all you have to do is go to edit, preferences, under the add-ons, search for cell fracture, just enable it and it should be available to use. Once you enable that, you can get back to your scene and select the object, click F3 and search for cell fracture. Now here are some options we can tweak to customize the kind of look we are going for. But before that, there's one very interesting thing which I explored is we can actually guide the cell fracture where the fractures need to happen using something called annotation pencil. Let's select the annotation tool here, and under this placement we need to change it to surface. Once that's done, or we can just select the object where we would want. So this is where the sphere is going to hit, and that's how the cracks should go. So I'm just going to draw some spider web kind of structure here so that it is able to guide the cell fracture add-on. I think this looks good. Let's go back to the select mode, and this is how it looks. Let's add the collider object. So for that, we can go ahead and add an icosphere. So we have the icosphere, we can change its subdivisions to 3 to make it a little smoother, and then we can select the object, W, shade smooth, and we can scale it down. Let's bring it up and we can even scale it down more. I think this looks well in proportion. Or GX, yeah. I think we can make it a little smaller, something like this. This looks good. We need to define its moment of impact. So now it's ready to go through this object like this, but before that, what we'll do is we'll add a camera. This will give us an angle to work with. If we go to the camera view, we can just go back. Okay, this is what we can work with, and let the object be here. Maybe we can move it a little bit up and we can move it out of the camera. This is where we can start the animation for this icosphere. Let's select the icosphere, I, and we can insert a keyframe. Let's go to 120th frame and let's change this to 120. Let's animate it something like 90. So let's move this on X axis and let's move this on Z axis to make it down. And we can insert keyframe. So now we see this icosphere is animated, it's passing through. And it's moving out of the camera angle. So we have both of the objects. Now what we can do is we can select the object. We can click F3 to get this option, cell fracture. So we have the annotation enabled. So we'll enable annotation pencil. I'll change the noise to 1. The struthers can stay the same. We are going to move it to broken 1. Let's click OK. So this is going to break the object and make it again. So this is how the broken object looks like. And it has been moved to a new collection. So for now, what we'll do is we'll just hide the default elements. Let's select this annotation pencil. And under here, menu, view, under tool, we don't need it now. So let's hide this annotation pencil and let's enable all of the broken pieces. Now if we select all of the broken objects, we can go to the object and rigid body and add as active. If we press play, it's going to obey the laws of gravity and fall down. Since it doesn't have any plane to react to, it's going down. If we go ahead and add a plane and scale it down up accordingly, and under the rigid body properties, if we change it to passive, now this plane is going to be the reactive object. So now if you press play, the object is going to fall to that plane, reacting to it. But we don't need the plane right now. Now what we need to figure out is how to keep all of the pieces intact till the object, till this icosphere hits it, and then the pieces of this statue fall to the ground. Right now it's just falling down. So to make sure it's standing, we just need to select all of the pieces, click one piece, and under the rigid body properties, under the dynamics, we need to enable deactivation and also enable start deactivated. And while we have all the objects selected, select object and rigid body and copy from active. Now if you see, it shouldn't fall to the ground like it was before, but if the psychosphere is passing through, it's not breaking, right? So to resolve that, if we play animation now, it's not reacting because we don't have any rigid body set to it. So we need to select the icosphere. Let's go to the rigid body property and add a rigid body, change it to passive, and change this to animated, like enable animated. Play this. So if we see, it's falling, the object is falling way earlier. Even before the object actually interacts, the object is falling. That is happening because the gravity is behaving at normal, whereas the sphere, it's not obeying the laws of physics, to say the least. It's passing very slow. So that's the reason it's not able to probably match up the physics behind it, and hence it's falling a little earlier. To fix that, we were actually planning something else with this. So for now, what we'll do is, let's just select the scene here. We have scene properties, and here we have the option of gravity. Now, if we disable the gravity, we don't have the 9.8 G of gravity applied to this scene. Now let's play the animation. Now it should interact just fine. Because we don't have any gravity to worry about, this object doesn't have to worry about any gravity constraints. It's able to trigger the brake when the object interacts. So this is what we were looking for, and we have that figured out. Now what we can do is we can start setting up a scene so that we can render something from this. Select this icosphere. We can use a material from the Quixel bridge again. So I'm going to use this brushed aluminium. So I have it downloaded in 2K resolution. I'll export this. We can select the icosphere, go to material. We can disable the first material which we assigned here in the dropdown. We'll find the brushed aluminium material here. So this is assigned to this icosphere, if you see. Good enough for this animation. Now we can go to the render engine. We'll change this to cycles, and let's change it to GPU compute. And for our workspace, I'm going to go with just 20 samples so that it's easy for us to check. We can start setting up the scene for now. Let's go ahead and add a plane. Let's scale it up till it covers the camera angle. So I'm going to use this texture for the flow. We can go ahead and export this again in the similar way. Go back to Blender and select the plane, go to material, and here we must be having that Roman mosaic. This texture looks good. So these are some assets I've downloaded already. This is what I'll be exporting. Let this asset be as it is. I'll just to mesh, add a plane, scale it up this, and RX 90 to rotate it. Then we can move this on the y-axis. This is the texture we can go with for the wall. It is just exported from bridge. Even if you're not using bridge, even if you are downloading some PBR textures from other websites, what we can do is we can go to shading, and we can select the plane, create a new material for it. And here we have the principled BSTF. If we download the PBR texture, we must be getting some files like this, the albedo, the displacement, the normal, the roughness. If we click principal BSDF, make sure we have Node Wrangler add-on enabled. Again, it comes default with Blender. So go to preferences and add-ons and search for node wrangler. Make sure it's enabled so that you can use it directly. So select principal BSDF, control shift T, and this would give it the option to directly import a PBR setup rather than selecting one image at a time. So I'm going to select all of the images. We don't need the preview and other files, we just need these images, and click principal texture setup. So it should assign that texture to it. But if you see now, this is scaled very incorrectly. So to resolve that, we have this mapping option. If I decrease the scale, it is going to change. If I increase the scale, it is going to change. So I'm going to just increase the scale as we want till it looks justifiable enough. Let's go back to layout mode. This is the setup we have right now. This is the object we have. We need to utilize this somewhere. For now, what I'll do is I'll just export this one. Since it's a broken piece, we can use this. So we have that broken piece here. We can just scale it up a little bit. We can bring it back. We can bring it here. We have that structure. We can simply rotate it like this. Looks good. I think that's enough. So this is what we have. And now is the time to add some lighting. But before that, let's go ahead and add a cube. Scale it till it fills out the entire scene. Go to shading and select the object, new. We can go ahead and delete the principal BSDF and add a volume scatter. Volume, plug it to volume. Let's change the density to 0.01. We can start adding some light. Spotlight first. Let's just scale it like this. Let's bring it up. The spot size as well. We don't need it to be that big. So this is what we have. Let's go to the camera view. Let's go to cycle. Let's go to the render output now. Let's start tweaking it. And increase this a little bit. We need to increase the spot size maybe. I'm going to change the world color to black. So now it's coming together, I believe. We play the animation. This is what we have. Looks cool, if you ask me.